Welcome to Karen Says Everyone. As always, I welcome you to my humble abode, aka the white wall, which I'm hoping for now my personality is enough to add a bunch of color to. And I thank you so much for inviting me into your space, whatever or wherever that may be. Now, if you've seen a few of my previous videos, A, thank you so much for still vibing with me, and B, you know that I try to incorporate a little bit of my cheesy, funny humor. Vegan saying cheesy. That's the humor I'm talking about right there. But while getting my points across, because I do think life is way, way too short to be so serious about everything, and life gets way too heavy if you just forget how to enjoy and take everything so seriously. So my hope with my channel is to impart some wisdom that I've learned, that things that have helped me, if I can help you grow in some way, learn something new, or get you thinking about the world in different ways while getting you to crack a smile or even just maybe a little bit of a laugh. If you watch my video feeling lighter, more upbeat, more positive, and learn something new or change your perspective somehow, then job done for the day. Because when you carry this kind of energy throughout your day, then A, you feel amazing all day. B, you make better decisions for yourself and for the world because your energy is just vibing up there. And C, you spread that energy forward to everyone else you come in contact with all day. Because I repeat, this is so important, as I have said before and will continue to always say, energy is contagious. Everybody say it with me, energy is contagious. If your energy is strong and positive and upbeat and you are constantly acting from a place of love and not fear, my friend, you can use that to change the entire world. But what happens when for some reason you feel the weight of the entire world on your shoulders and this little pit in your stomach that just doesn't seem to go away? With all due seriousness in this video, I felt it very important to do this video because I feel like a lot of people are starting 2020 off with this very weird kind of anxiety, and there's almost this tangible tension in the air. Despite the winter blues, that's not what I'm even addressing in this video, because I feel like there is something bigger that needs to be addressed that's affecting everyone, which is this. Everywhere you turn right now, it seems like the world is in turmoil. We have literally just begun a new year, and there's already memes being spread about World War III. Australia is in a very dire situation right now. There's headlines about massacres, rape, global warming. The list goes on and on. It's endless, and it's very, very heavy stuff to deal with. But also thinking about these situations that you hear day to day with a new perspective can really shift your mindset. I have three perspective shifts that I want to share with you today so that you can apply it whenever you're feeling the weight of the world on your shoulders, and hopefully that makes a difference in how you feel. So whenever you're feeling this way, take this kind of introspective approach. Number one, relevancy. For one, think about these situations in relevance to your everyday life situations. If you were upset and crying about losing one of your AirPods today, then really, really think about these other situations you're hearing about that are very life and death and a lot more significance than when you compare it to losing an AirPod. Looking at the situation this way and comparing it to your own situations really shifts how you think about the problems that seem so big in your world but really aren't when you look at the rest of the world. Now, that's not to minimize you feeling bad about having a bad day, because we are all human, we all go through our ups and downs, and it's very natural. And it's not to make you feel guilty about having first world problems either, because again, that is a very natural human tendency. Because if you are used to a certain level of comfort, then obviously something that is a little step below seems uncomfortable and we tend to complain about it. So feeling like that is perfectly normal. But this perspective shift is merely to broaden your mind and your perspective so that the big, big problems in your life don't seem so big anymore when you compare it to all the other issues going on. Number two, say bye-bye to the victim mindset. For this perspective shift, you really want to get away from the victim mindset of not being able to do anything about a situation and regain your sense of power. There are two kinds of people when dealing with any kind of situation, whether it be personal, professional, or whether it be worldly. You got ones that feel bad about it and do nothing about it, and ones that feel bad about it and actually do something about it. Whenever you're feeling bad about a situation that's happening in the world, understand that that is perfectly normal and a good thing to be empathetic to what other people are going through in the world. But please also understand that you are willingly giving up your sense of power by doing nothing to resolve that guilty and bad feeling and just feeling like you can't do anything about that situation and being the helpless victim. Other people, on the other hand, realize that they have the power to do something about a situation, even if it's happening on the other side of the world. Organize a fundraiser, raise a protest, or just use your voice to influence the community around you for a certain change. Being able to do something about a situation gives you such a release from that pit in the stomach feeling of being a helpless victim because it gives you your sense of power back. And I'll tell you one thing in relation to this point as well. Some of you, maybe you can't hold a fundraiser for some reason, you can't go to a protest for another reason, whatever. You still have immense power. How is that, Karen? As a consumer, this is where business Karen comes out. Every single one of you is a consumer, including me. So every time you choose to partake in a service or buy a product, every time you do something or buy something, you are casting your vote for what you believe in and what you support. Or you are also casting a vote against what you don't support. And there is tremendous power in that. I choose to support environmental activism as well as animal rights. So I choose to remain a vegan for over a year now, so I don't purchase meat, for example. So I recognize that there is power in my choice and thus my voice. So I don't feel helpless towards climate change because I know there's things that I do for it, like being a vegan, making sure I actively recycle whenever I can, reducing the amount that I consume just in general. Hashtag fun fact, I used to be a shopaholic back in the day, which is why I have quite the collection of clothes and jewelry and stuff, but I have significantly reduced the amount that I shop and I consume now because I am more aware about what that leads to in terms of larger implications for productions and factories and how all of that affects climate change. And I gladly talk about these issues whenever the chance comes up with my non-vegan friends and family, with my friends and family who don't know what to do about climate change. I do my part to educate people on what I know, which is also why I started this channel. Because combined together, we have amazing power to change the world. And such power and positivity comes in knowing that. And that is an amazing, amazing way to get rid of your anxiety about all the world issues that are going on right now. Number three, humility. So this third perspective is quite a hard pill to swallow for some, but I've had a lot of time to do self-reflection and think about my place in the universe, so I've come to this conclusion. And this perspective shift takes a bit of humility and quite the deep dive into your own place in the universe. Sometimes our perspectives, our problems, our lives seem so big that we just can't really see anything else that's going on around us. And we give them more importance than they actually deserve or they actually are. We often forget that the world is a lot bigger than just us and our problems and how we individually feel about things. Once we go from this life, not many people will remember us. And even those who do remember us will remember us time to time, but eventually they'll expire away too, and off will come a new generation, and so on and so forth. If this can be said for us and our place in the world, don't you think this can be said about the world and its place in the universe? Our world is such a small little corner of the vast galaxy of the unknown. And yet in the small little corner, there seems to be so many issues going on. And we pay so much attention to that, which we obviously should, because as I said before, it's our home. But we oftentimes still forget that this world is still such a small little part of something huge that we are all a part of. So sometimes if nothing else works, it's often really comforting, I find, to think about how small and insignificant we are in comparison to everything else, versus always thinking about us and how big our feelings are, how big our problems are, even as the world. All in all, Kiran says, please use this as motivation to not take life so seriously. Because it's far too easy to just waste away your life under this mounting pressure of the world that's just not gonna go away if you don't do anything about it. And I don't want your life to be like that. You deserve so much more. You deserve happiness. You deserve to enjoy this human experience and to grow and learn, which is what it is designed for us to do. So yes, make sure to pay attention to what's going on in your home, in the world, and take action whenever you can and when necessary. But also please balance it out with just reveling in the small moments of joy and laughter and just not taking life so seriously from moments to moments. Please do that for your own mental health and your own well-being and just for that amazing energy to flow. Think about it this way. I said before and will continue to always say, let's repeat it everyone, energy is contagious. So if we all walk around the world with depressing, down energy, all negative Nancy's all the time, the world is gonna be such a depressing place, and that's what it's slowly becoming. We need as much good energy to lift the world up and the world's energy up and just continue to spread that positive, upbeat energy and keep increasing the frequency of those around us so that the world doesn't become a drab place. So to those that are keeping the energy up, good job, you are doing amazing things. And to the others who feel the mounting pressures, please, please take the appropriate steps necessary to get yourself away from this anxiety, because that is the last thing I want you to feel every single day and walk around not knowing why you feel depressed and anxious about this year all the time and you're constantly stressing about the world. I really hope these perspective shifts shift the way you think and they help you releasing that anxious feeling. Until next time, wishing all of you amazing, happy, positive, upbeat vibes. Till next time. Peace. Oh hey, give this video a like if you agree with the perspective shifts that I was talking about. And I urge you to please, please, please share this video with your family and friends and anyone who you know is feeling anxious about the year. Make sure you spread that positive energy forward so that we can all feel a little less anxious, a little more happy and positive about where we can take the new year, not necessarily about where it started. And if you vibed with my vibes, then please make sure to subscribe for more Karen Says every single week. See you next time.